Welcome back, everyone, to more Let's Play Final Fantasy VIII. In the last episode, we won a rare card again, and we spread a rule. And in this episode, we're going to have a meeting that involves strategers. This is Zell. Try not to shake his hand, because he usually puts his hand in places. Yeah. It's like, hi everyone, even though it's only us three, pretty much. There they go. Yeah, I'm gonna walk. I don't feel like being like Zell and running. Because it's only like 15, 20 feet away. I can't measure distance by eye. This is a full-scale operation. Our resistance, the Forest Elves, will be forever known in the pages of Timber's Independence. Exciting, huh? It all started when we got a hold of a top secret information from Galbadia. There's a VIP from Galbadia going to Timber. The guy's name is Venzer Delling, our arch enemy and the president of Galbadia. Oh great, so apparently their arch enemy is a president of Galbadia. And he's a dictator. Okay, that's just fantastic. Yeah, now he's gonna try to explain a plan here, and I like Selfie's idea a lot better than what they've got going. So get to the point, just tell us what to do. Alright, so this is pretty much what we're going to be doing. So we see all these models here, and the base is at the top right where we are, and the dummy car is... You know what, you can read it. I don't even feel like having to explain it. Because the game will do it itself, but I could summarize what will happen. An overly complicated plan, pretty much. That's what's going to happen. Now, for the most part, whenever you're reading this, by the way, you can almost completely ignore it and still do a fine job. Alright, so apparently Delling is antisocial and he doesn't like the, he doesn't like people being with him. So we have to uncouple cars without being detected on a train. Alright, we have the dummy car and our base moving in after the uncoupling. Somehow connect them to the other compartments of the train without people noticing. You know, unless if these trains don't have windows, I see major flaws with this plan. Major, major flaws. And we pretty much steal the president. Yeah, that's what happens. Alright, by the way, if you actually end up doing this without screwing up a single time, your seed rank will go up by one. But we can always just take tests to do that anyways, but I don't feel like it. Because I don't really have to. I'm not at all worried about my seed rank, trust me, viewers. Yeah, the guards have a sound sensor and a temperature sensor. Alright, viewers, this part is very important to not pay attention to. Now, there's a very good reason why. Because at this point, whenever you're running across the train, whenever you're first starting, for whatever reason, their sensors do not work, and it's part of the story. So it's not a glitch or anything, it's literally part of the story to where they're just like, hey, my sensor's not working. What gives, man? So, yeah, you don't have to stop or run. You can just keep going. How can you uncouple the cars from a moving train? Alright, so we have to tamper with the control system. If we temporarily disable the circuit for the connection, the car will uncouple automatically, and we have codes! So, it goes 1, 2, 3, 4 in a, what is it? I'm gonna call it bizarro clockwise motion. It's not in the clock. Wait, no, it isn't clockwise. Never mind. I'm being a dumbass. Ignore me. All right, so 3, 1, 2, 4 would be square X circle. Shit, I wasn't even looking at what he said. I was looking at something else. And you have 5 seconds to do it. Which, I mean, by all means, that's more than enough time. Alright, enter 3 codes, and if you want to quit, just hold down 1. So, 3, 4, 2, 3. 3, 4, 2, 3. 1, 2, 4, 3. And then code 3 is 1, 4, 1, 1. Jeez. At least give it some challenge. That's just like making your password on your computer password. By the way, this model's nice, but the president's car looks pretty shabby. Why is that? Okay, Renault made it. Everything else they bought at a gift store. Oh, goodness. And Squall completely agrees. And she supposedly made it look like that on purpose. And it represents her hatred towards Delling. Zell's not biting it, or biting. Yeah, he's not going for it. Oh, that's great. Yeah, I pretty well understood it from the get-go. So let's decide on the party. For my Let's Play, for the most part, I'm going to be, whenever I get the chance, just putting in the lowest level people in my party, for the most part. I mean, there may be a couple of moments to where I'm not going to, and there's a very specific reason why I wouldn't, but for the most part, it's going to be lower levels. And we are now moving again. Huzzah! Talk to Watts when you're ready. The sooner the better. Right. Let's take a look at this stuff first. Yeah, it's clipping from a magazine. Galbadia's dictator, President Vinzer Delling, special. How does he stay in power? Reveal his darkest secrets. President Delling became the president after the Second Sorcerer's War ended. To gain support quickly, he carried out the invasion of Timber. Okay, so that's why Timber hates his ass. I forget how many clippings there are. I think there are like 4 or 5. To imprison anti-government sympathizers, the D-District prison was built in the desert south of Delling City. Millions were spent to build the facility. The threat of being sent to prison was something or another. Yeah, not reading it anymore. Yeah, don't remember that prison for later, viewers. It has no... It's not relevant to the plot at all. Not at all. Okay, yeah, there were 4 issues here. With the expectation of S-Star, the Galbadian military possesses the world's only long-range missiles. Although never used in combat, their existence has become a worldwide threat. It is said that the missiles have the ability to hit any target with astounding accuracy, even without using radio signals. Will the time come for the president to push the button? When the time comes, tit! Yep, that was it. Okay, yeah. That was a little bit interesting to get some backstory on Delling there, but, you know, for the most part, not really necessary. And not at all relevant to the plot, I swear. I swear, viewers. So if you run back here, you can actually see the president dumb. You know, the president's dummy. I'm in a bad mood right now. If there's nothing in particular, I order you to leave immediately. Yeah, it looks totally real, but does it sound real? That is the only question. So anyways, if we run back here before leaving, you can grab Pet's Pal Volume Number 2. So without further ado on that one, I'm going to, hold on, no. I need to read it first. I keep forgetting to do that. So let's go ahead and read that. And we can learn Angelo Recover. So, yeah. Now I'm going to be able to start learning that. Which I'm not at all Oh. Okay, well, apparently Angelo Strike is necessary. Well, not really necessary. I'll learn that first then. Okay, whatever. So, yeah. Whenever we continue to run around, Angelo will start to learn it slowly but surely. Wait a second. Okay, so somehow or another, they got unequipped from them. Squall is the only one who has stuff junction. What the hell? Yeah, I'm gonna give you Dean McGee and Fluffy. Yeah, sure, why not? So we got Jiwo. Magic. Draw. Magic. Card. And I'll just make the magic stuff. Alright, there we go. Now, I don't know why they unequip your GFs, though. That just makes no sense. So anyways, yeah, we're pretty well ready to go. Yes, we already looked at the president's dummy. If you haven't, please take a look-see. It's like a piece of art. I know the kidnapping plan must be tough, but best of luck to you. Yeah, we're pretty well ready. I have full confidence in my ability to do this flawlessly. Oh yeah, by the way, if you try to walk here, you can actually make your characters crawl. It's funny, just seeing that. Oh my god, it looks like Sophie has her head up Zell's ass. I'm never gonna get that image out of my head now. Alright, so we have 5 minutes to complete the operation, so yeah, I'm pretty much gonna fit the rest of this into this one episode. So right here, I wonder if we could jump if we... Oh, okay, I have to hit X to jump. I couldn't just simply crawl over there. Yeah, see, with the sound of the temperature sensor, if you stay there long enough, you can hear a conversation between the two, and it's actually kind of funny. So now we're going to get ready for the first uncoupling here. Once again, it's not at all difficult. All you have to do is hit the right button combinations, and you're good to go. Oh yeah, and also don't get caught. That's 27. Hey, that's my lucky number. How many more times do you plan to disturb me with my meaningless report? Yeah, it's his duty to just constantly say, yeah, everything's cool, bro. Huh. There goes next month's paycheck. Wow. Galbadia must have a pretty strict pay cuts right there. And now he's not going to be able to propose to his fiance, or, well, soon-to-be fiance. This is the first escort. Like Watts said, there should be 2 guards on this car. Selfie and Zell, you guys keep an eye on the guards. So they'll let me know in advance whenever people are coming. And so, yeah. Don't let them catch you, because if they catch you, then you'll have to restart or just not take a seed ring, pretty much. Yeah, we have to hold L1, so. Yeah, I remember how to enter stuff. And now we have to get the cable ready, so. Yeah. Alright, 4 minutes left. Well, more like four and a half. Alright, 4, 4, 2, 3. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and pull back up really quick, because usually, yeah, blue and red like to go over there whenever you enter in one. I'm pretty sure I could have sneaked in two, but I'll be able to get both of them here shortly. Whenever they both turn back, I'll just be able to do two at one. So, there we go. Now we can go back down. 3, 4, 1, 1. Code 2 confirmed. And now code 3 is 1, 4, 2, 3. And that's all the codes for this train. I'm crawling, it's funny. I feel like Metal Gear Solid now. Only not so Metal Gear-y. I don't know why I'm just entertaining myself by crawling, it's funny. Hey, look, you got a newspaper now. That's awesome. Sir, everything's in order, sir. Hey, he's not angry. What gives? Oh, wait, he's reading a newspaper. I wonder where he got it. He pulled it out of his ass. I'm in a bad mood right now. If there's nothing in particular, I order you to leave immediately. You don't just stand there, be back to your station. Wow. 2 months' paycheck in one day. Just holy crap. He must be on a salary if that's the case. So apparently the interior here looks crappier. Just leave Galbadia. I'm pretty sure you could get a decent paying job elsewhere. So the second escort, from here we're home free. And there are two guards on this one, so Zell and Selfie are up ahead working on uncoupling another train, and for whatever reason, Renault is not able to keep an eye for us, so we have to do it ourselves. Yes, I know how to do the codes, I did it not even 2 minutes ago. All right, let's see here. Yeah, they're fine. Let's go down and enter in one code, and there, that go back up and repeat. 2, 4, 2, 1. Yeah, go back up, go back up. There we go. And now I'm just gonna wait for them to walk back, and whenever they, you know, leave the door, I'll go ahead and go down and do the other two codes again. That, in my opinion, is probably the best way to take care of this without getting caught, so. Yeah, now that they're out of the way, let's go ahead and do the last two. 4, 1, 4, 2. Two, four, two, two. And let's see. Wait a second, did I have more codes or was that it? Oh wait, no, I had two more to do. Okay, yeah, they're gonna come back anyway, so it's fine. So I will just go back down whenever they leave again, and after that, do the other two codes and go from there. Okay, yeah, they've already left. I thought that the blue guy didn't quite make it to that door yet. 4, 3, 2, 2. Whoa, kind of didn't want to work there, X button. 1, 4, 3, 3. And that is all of the codes, and I did it without getting caught too, so that means my seed rank will go up by one. Not like I really care though. Raiders of the Lost Ark! I'm no expert, but I'm pretty sure people would feel if the cars, you know, were like jamming up by each other like that. I don't know, maybe it's just me overthinking it because it's just, you know, Final Fantasy. It's a damn fictional plot. So we've waited so long for this encounter with Mr. Delling. Yep, so he says, was that perfect, sir? Yes, it was perfect. So, you see, seed rank went up by a whopping one. Which means I'll just be getting 1,000 more gil every time I run around enough. Do they have a bathroom or something on this train? Alright, so she's gonna begin serious negotiations with the president himself. Better make sure my GF's equipped. Yeah, that would be fairly important, by the way, which I've already done that. And it looks like I won't have to do it again, so I'm not at all worried about it. So on that note, I'm going to stop recording right now, and I would like to say thank you all for watching Let's Play Final Fantasy VIII. In the next episode, we're gonna go confront the president, and we're gonna put a stop to his plans.